Welcome to the VEX Robotics Competition referee training videos, designed for both referees and teams. This is Chapter 10, VEX U. VEX U is the university-level version of the VEX Robotics Competition, intended to provide a unique competition opportunity for university students. VEX U teams play the same game and use the same field layout as VRC teams, but there are a few twists that keep the competition fresh and enable students to explore collegiate-level manufacturing and programming challenges. In this video, we're not going to look at every difference, just a few of the major ones that will impact referees the most. Namely, two robot teams, the autonomous period, and the different robot materials that are now allowed in VEX U. First, two robots. VRC teams build one robot that fits within an 18-inch cube and are randomly allied with partners to create two team alliances of 18-inch robots. In VEX U, teams build two robots, thus essentially creating their own two robot alliance. One of these robots must start within a 24-inch cube and the other must start in a 15-inch cube. Remember, there are no expansion limits in VRC Tower Takeover. As long as each robot fits in the designated sizing cubes before the match, they're allowed to expand as much as they want once the match starts. The next major change to gameplay that referees should be aware of is the increased emphasis on autonomous programming. In VEX U, the autonomous period at the beginning of every match lasts for 45 seconds, and the driver control period is shortened to 75 seconds. This is intended to encourage collegiate teams to develop advanced autonomous routines. However, if both teams complete their routines before 45 seconds has passed, they may signal to the referee that they wish to end early and go straight to the driver control. This is usually done with a crossed arm symbol and a verbal confirmation. And finally, the most significant difference between VEX U teams and their VRC counterparts, VUR2 and VUR3. VUR2 states the following: teams may use any official VEX Robotics product other than the exceptions noted below to construct their robot. The most common implication of this rule will be the inclusion of VEX Pro components into VEX U robots. The VEX Pro product line includes a vast array of wheels, gearboxes, and hardware that VEX U teams may find interesting. The VersaFrame system will be especially useful for teams who wish to use the new array of aluminum stock and gussets for robot construction. So, referees and inspectors may need to familiarize themselves with the product line before arriving at the competition. This is an example of a VEX U legal drivetrain built entirely out of VEX Pro components. As if that wasn't enough, VUR3 is where the robots will really start looking different. VUR3 states the following: teams are allowed to fabricate their own unique components from the following additional raw materials for each of their robots: an unlimited amount of these various plastics, an unlimited amount of silicone, polyurethane, or other rubber, an unlimited amount of composite materials such as G10 or Garolite, FR4 or carbon fiber, an unlimited number of plastic 3D printed parts, an unlimited amount of steel and aluminum. The intent of VUR3 is to encourage teams to explore advanced fabrication techniques like milling or 3D printing. In order to permit this, we had to make these raw materials legal. However, the intent is not to legalize commercially available items that are made from these materials. The difference is a bit subtle on paper, but should become clear in practice. Did you machine this bracket yourself out of aluminum bar stock? Or did you purchase it as a bracket from an online store? Did you design the plastic wheel in the CAD and then 3D print it? Or did you purchase it from an RC car shop? Referees and inspectors will need to be diligent and be willing to ask these types of questions if you see something that looks unfamiliar. Similarly, teams who wish to utilize custom components should be prepared to answer these questions or provide supporting documentation when asked. We look forward to seeing how VEX U teams will take advantage of these new opportunities to push competitive VEX robots to another level. That's all for Chapter 10 of the 2019-2020 referee training videos. If you haven't already, be sure to check out the other chapters in the series. The official game manual for VRC Tower Takeover can be found on vexrobotics.com and roboticseducation.org. If you have any questions about rules that were not covered in this video series, please refer to the official Q&A. Have a great 2019-2020 season.